So this one is just the example how to calculate the payback period for another project S. Use the same use this number, you will get the payback period would be 1.6 year. What's the meaning? It means you get back your initial investment within 1.6 year. Okay? That's the interpretation. Now we move on to the next one. This one, the summary. The strength of payback period. Even though payback period is the easiest one, it has a very key strength. It in some for certain perspective, it is better than NPV or IRR. Why? Because listen to me. Because payback period gives you the only thing that gives you the riskiness and the liquidity of your project. Payback period gives you this perspective. Like other number won't give you this perspectives. Payback period gives you the riskiness and the liquidity of your investment project. That the investment project that has a short payback period, let's say 1 year, 2 year, is less, much less risky than the project that has a payback period of 10 years. You agree? Payback period of 2 years is much less risky than the project with 10 years. So it tells you the riskiness of the project. Also, it also tells you the liquidity of the project. So if the payback period is low, it means you get back your money quicker. So you have more liquidity. So this one is very important. It's the only criteria that tell you this. NPV, IRR, MIR, or other fancy thing does not tell you this simple picture, simple message. Okay. So this one is very important. So it doesn't matter whether you calculate NPV or IRR, you should always calculate payback period. Always calculate payback period. The second strength is it is easy to calculate. However, though, some weaknesses for payback. First, it ignores TVM. What is TVM? Time value of money. It presumes that the value of money is always the same, no matter whether you receive it now or 100 years from now, the same value, which is not true. Also, this one can be collected. If you use discount payback period, it can be collected. It is still redeemable, this problem. However, the second one is irredeemable. It's the weakness, inherent weakness of the payback period. It ignores cash flow that occurs after the payback period. So let's say two projects payback at the same time 2 years from now. We cannot tell which one is better. Because payback period does not care what is the cash flow after 2 years. So it will give you just the same number, 2 years. They don't, even though one project can, give you more cash flow after 2 years for another 10 years. Another project will just give you one more cash flow or something. So payback period does not give you this one, and it is the major weakness. Okay, this one, the example of discount payback. When you talk about discount, it means you need a discount rate, and it is important. The discount rate that you need to use must be the WACC of the project. The discount rate that you use must be the WACC of the project. This one is WACC. In this case, 10%. Okay? So the first thing that you need to know, you find the present value of all cash flow. Since this 100 minus 100 baht happened now, so the present value is also minus 100. Since this 10 baht will happen 1 year from now, so the present value would be 10 divided by 1 plus 10%, right? So 1.1. Yes? What is the present value of this 60? It will be 60 divided by 1.1 to the power of 2, because 2 years. Now you get this number. This one is 80 divided by 1.1 to the cube. Divided by 1.1 to the cube. Okay. Now you do the same technique, right? You calculate cumulative discount cash flow. Cumulative discount cash flow, right? So this one minus 100, still minus, so it means you still have a loss. Minus, since on the third year you have a positive number already, so it means in terms of present value, you must break even between year 2 and year 3. We assume that for the whole year, from 2 to 3, you get 18.79 as a whole year. You need only, right? Sorry, you get this one, 60.11 for the whole year. Since you need only 41.32, right, to break even. So what proportion of the year? So the proportion would be 41.32 over 60.11. It is 0.7 of the year. So the discount payback of this project is 2.7. And if you notice which one is higher, payback period or discount payback, which one should be higher? The discount payback. Right. Most of the time, discount payback will be higher than payback period. All of the time, right? Always. Right? Discount payback will be higher than the payback period. Let's say if your project could not let's say if you cannot calculate payback period for your project, what does it mean? If you cannot calculate the discount payback payback period for your project, what does it mean? Yeah, it means you don't get your money back. That's all. Say you invest 100, the first year you get 10, the second year you take 10, and then no more cash flow. It means you cannot calculate the payback period because there is none. You never get back. So if you use this one and you cannot get the number, it usually means you don't get back. You don't get back your initial investment. Clear? Okay. Nice. Mess me up. What is the next one? Okay, the next one is the NPV. I need to spend... Oh, okay, let me finish it quickly. We still have precious another 5 minutes. So let me enjoy commenting you a bit further. Right? You enjoy being commented? Yes? Oh, you are what we call masochist. You like to be tormented, right? All of you learn the NPV, right? It stands for net present value, right? Net present value, right? Net present value. Basically, let's finish the technique first for NPV, right? For NPV, you calculate the present value of every cash flow. Calculate the present value of every cash flow. When you calculate the present value, you use the WACC of the project as the discount factor. Say this one, it is 10 over 1.1. This one is 60 over 1.1 square, 80 over 1.1 cube. Then you get this present value. You sum all the present value of all cash flow, and then you get the NPV of the project. That is the technical meaning of NPV. Technical meaning. In terms of financial or economic meanings, it means that how much this project would add value to the firm. This number tells you how much this project would add value to the firm. So it means, in this case, it means if the firm decides to do this project, the value of the whole firm will increase by 18.79. It means the increase in the value of the firm if it decides to do this project. That is the economic or financial meaning. Right. Value of the firm means the value of the debt. Value of the firm means the value of the equity plus the value of the debt. Right. It does not care who gets the cash flow. Right. You care only the total size of the pie. So value of the firm means you don't care who provide the cash flow, who will get which part. You care the total size of the pie. We call that the value of the firm. It would equal the value of equity plus the value of the debt. So it means if the firm decide to do this project, the value of the firm which will be distributed among equity and debt will increase by this much. 18.79. That's the key. Clear? Okay. So the firm should decide to do the project only if what? Only if NPV is positive. If NPV is negative or zero, then the firm should not do the project. However, let's say you have two mutually exclusive projects, right? And they have the number like this. Project A, project B. Project A has mutually exclusive, right? Project A has an NPV of 100. Project B has an NPV of 80. Which one should you do? What would be your decision? You do A, right? So for mutually exclusive project, you do the project with the highest positive NPV, right? You do the project with the highest positive NPV. Another example, let's say for if A and B are mutually exclusive projects, NPV of A is minus 20, NPV of B is 0. What would be your investment decision? You do neither, right? You don't do anything. You don't do A and you don't do B, okay? Again, let's say if it is that's about it, huh? About it. No more aspect. Okay, move on. Okay, this one is another example NPV of the project S. Make sure that you can calculate all this NPV using your financial calculator. Make sure that you can do it. So I finished NPV. I already finished this. Okay. So let me repeat again. For independent project, the firm should do every project that has positive NPV for independent project. For mutually exclusive project, right? The firm should do the project with the highest, positive, right? Highest. And must be positive, right? Positive. NPV. Right? Must be positive. Right? Okay, I think that's about it. Right? So enjoy your evening. I feel sad I cannot continue to torment you a bit further.